Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a very much requested Midway Helix update. As you know, this was my most recent piercing, well, besides my tragus, which you guys saw a few days ago. That is my newest one, but I recently got this one done as well. My Midway Helix is this one right here, right in the middle of my ear. I got that done about a month ago now, which is crazy. Like, I swear, just time goes faster and faster, and I just can't keep up. But yes, it already has been a month, and I just figured I would give you guys a little bit of an update. If you guys want to see me get the actual piercing, click here, or if you are interested in my tragus piercing, click here. So whichever one you want to see, go ahead and give it a click, but also make sure that you go down in the description box and click on the link to my tattoos and piercings playlist where you can see a whole bunch of other stuff going on. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. So on the 19th of November, I got this piercing done, and I've always kind of wanted this piercing. Like, it's always kind of been in the back of my mind, but after my upper helix finally healed, I was like, I cannot do another cartilage helix piercing. I just can't do it. They were so incredibly difficult to heal. So I was questioning. I was like, I don't know if I can handle it right now, but I ended up going to get it. If you guys did watch the video where I did get it pierced, it was $10. And for those of you who are going to leave a comment about the price, I don't give a flying fuck what you think a good price is or not. Regardless, it's my piercings, my body, my money. I will do whatever I want with it. I don't care if you guys think it's a, you know, trashy price for a piercing. I don't really care. I've never had an issue with any of my piercings. They are all fine. Just keep your opinions to yourself. And another thing too is when I changed my upper helix into this earring, which is just a regular butterfly back little diamond, people went ballistic. People were like, you're not allowed to wear rings like that. You can't wear rings like that. Like, this one girl was like, I work in a tattoo and piercing shop and you're supposed to have a flat back. You're supposed to? Is that like a law or something? Like, I don't give a fuck where you work. Like, I will wear whatever I want in my piercings. Like, it, and honestly, like, I kid you not, I have had no issues, no problems whatsoever with this one at all. It feels fine, it looks fine, I like it. Just people were just being so stupid about it. Like, they were just being so dumb about what I was putting in it. They were like, oh my god, you can't do that. Like, shut up. I got it pierced, like I said, November 19th. It is an 18 gauge CBR ring, or ball closure ring, whatever you want to call it, which just means it is just the little hoop with the little ball in the middle. If you want to know how to take those in and out, you can watch the video where I changed this one, because this one was pierced with the exact same ring. A lot of people are like, 18 gauge, that's kind of weird. Not really. I like to have 18 gauge because I like to wear these types of earrings in my piercing, so that doesn't really bug me at all. Like, if I wanted to, I could, you know, stretch it to a 16 gauge. Like, it's really no big deal, but it is an 18 gauge. It's really not a big deal. I like it. As far as pain goes, yes, this one did hurt a lot more than my upper one did. Like, the pinch was a lot harder. Oh, and I washed my hands. Don't fucking freak out. I can just see the comments. Just, oh, you touched your piercing. But yeah, it did hurt a little bit more than my upper one, but it really was totally bearable. I totally got through it. I didn't flinch too bad, so it was totally fine. So as far as healing goes, I'm just gonna kind of explain to you how it's been going the last month. It has been going surprisingly well. Feeling a lot better than my upper one did. I don't know why that is, but usually, okay. So when I get helix piercings or any type of cartilage piercings, my ears hate those. No matter what, my ear just gets pissed at me. So the first day was fine, you know, it was fine and dandy, you know, I cleaned it, did my thing. And then days 2, 3, and 4 were absolute hell. I kid you not, I was in so much pain. I really should have took a picture of it because it looked so bad. My ear in this general area swelled up so bad, Oh my god, it was awful. I don't know why. It's every time I get like a piercing in this general area, my ear just gets really, really, really angry for like 4 days. So I was in so much pain. I was constantly making ice in the freezer to like hold it up to my ear. I was constantly just, I was taking ibuprofen like crazy. I was putting hot compresses, holding ice on it. It was just not a good time. So I was major pain, major redness, major swelling. Like, my ear was like out to like here. It was it was huge. My ear was so bad looking. I didn't film for those days because it looked so bad, and so many people would have been like, oh my God, something is wrong with your ear. So I just didn't even film. I just stayed in bed and just held ice to my ear. It was so bad. After that, like miraculously, it just went down, and it has been doing great ever since. I do still clean it. I clean it about 1 to 2 times a day. Definitely every day in the shower with my Provan soap. If you are interested in getting Provan soap, you can get it off of Amazon for a reasonably price. So I really recommend that for your piercings. And I also do sea salt soaks as well. So when I do my sea salt soaks, I take my non-iodized sea salt and I put 1/4 or just kind of a guesstimate amount into my little medicine cup. And what I would do for my sea salt is I would just kind of dip my ear into the little medicine cup like this and hold it there for 5 minutes. I would do that every once in a while too. And this, doing the sea salt soaks also really helped with the really, really bad days. So the days when it was really, really bad and really big and swollen, sea salt soaks were amazing and it really did help. So that pretty much is how I handled those first couple of days of pure hell. Yeah, ever since then, it's been healing really, really well. It is to the point where I can sleep on it because my tragus piercing is still very, very fresh. Like, my tragus piercing is only like 6 days old on the day that I'm filming this, so it is still very, very sore and tender. So luckily, this is, you know, not painful to the point where like I can sleep on it at night. Sometimes if I sleep a little too hard on this ear at night, it does get a little angry, but I just do a sea salt soak in the morning and it's good to go. So it has been healing really well. I'll go ahead and zoom in so you guys can see it. I still have a little bit of sea salt just on my ear from when I cleaned it this morning, which I need to clean it again soon because it's been quite a while since I woke up. So just kind of ignore that. So here's what it looks like 1 month later. As you can see, it is a little bit crusty, which is normal. And then here's what the back of it looks like. As you can see, it's got little tiny crusties on it. I figured I would just leave those in the video for you guys so you can kind of see what they look like. So if any of you are experiencing the same kind of healing process, not to worry, those little crusties are completely and totally normal. I really do like this piercing. As you can see, it was pierced just above this little vein right here. Thank God. I can't imagine what it would have been like to go through that vein. Like, that would have just been pure hell. I really like having these kind of rings for helix piercings because when I do, like I said, when I get these types of piercings, I swell up really, really bad. And the ring really allows for me to swell to the maximum capacity that it does, because if I had a barbell in this, like, my ear would have just swallowed the barbell. So I really like having rings like this for my healing ear piercings. I just like it like that. So that is basically everything that I have to update you guys on this piercing. You guys really wanted an update, and I wasn't really gonna do one because, you know, it's just like a helix piercing, but a lot of people overlook these piercings because they're like, oh, it's an ear piercing, whatever. But in actuality, these piercings can sometimes be really hard to heal, and they can be very painful to heal as well. So I figured I would go ahead and throw an update up on my channel for you guys so you guys could get kind of an idea of how it's going. I hope it continues to, you know, keep going amazing. If you guys want to see an update on my tragus piercing as well, I will probably also wait for a little after 1 month to give you guys an update on it. So if you guys do want that, let me know in the comments and I will get that up for you as soon as I can, because I am going to Florida very, very, very soon. So I won't have time to like film videos. So just wanted to get that out of the way. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this update. If you have any questions for me, go ahead and leave them in the comments and I will try to get back to you as soon as I can. But until then, I will see you guys very soon in my next video. Bye guys.